ravages the Eastern Front, leaving over a million Ukrainians internally displaced or seeking refuge in other countries. Thousands have perished in this senseless war. As Canadians living in a free nation where human rights and the rule of law are upheld, where differences are not only tolerated but celebrated, where ordinary citizens have some of the highest standards of living anywhere on the planet, we are called on to help our friends in need. This concert continues Canada's long-standing tradition of supporting Ukraine from grassroots humanitarian initiatives to advocacy on Ukraine's behalf on the world arena. Funds raised at this concert, both through donations and CD sales, will be donated to the Military Medical Center, West Region, in Lviv of Ukraine. Today's concert will begin with a short prelude on homage to Ukraine. This is an opportunity for all of us to gather as a community and reflect on the current situation through the medium of poetry, music, and dance. We will begin with Natalia Melish reciting her poem, Molitva. Natalia is a multi-talented leader in our Ukrainian-Canadian community in Calgary. The English can be found in the texts and translations booklets. Her poem will be followed immediately by Ballad of the Holy Hawks, one of the great Ukrainian composers, Volodymyr Ivasyuk's most plaintive songs to those affected by war. Irena Melnik-Kalinovich will join Stephania and the musicians for this song. She is a vocalist and bandura player who is trained in the Lviv Conservatory and currently is the conductor of the Korinya Ukrainian Folk Choir. Also performing original choreography will be ballerina Tanya Chumak, a dancer who performs for the Alberta Ballet and prior to that in lead roles with the New York Theatre Ballet. Out of respect for the solemnity of this montage, we ask that you hold your applause during and after these two pieces.
Так хочеться, щоб сонечко світило, і всі ми жили в милі і добрі. Всевишній Боже, дай нам грішним сили за мир цей вистояти в боротьбі. Ми молимо, прости провини наші, наші гріхи, благаємо відпусти. Дай жити нам у любові і благодаті, від злоби людської народ наш захисти. Не дай розп'яти нашу Україну, роздерти її бідну на шматки. Сотні синів лягли у домовину, їм вічна пам'ять. Ти їх родинам поможи. Дай їм душевний біль здолати, що принесли в наш дім московські кати. І гідних, подвигових батьків, дітей навчати любові до землі, де народились я і ти. Ти поможи ніколи не забути, за що боролись і до чого йшли, і з обраного шляху не звернути, від зради і спокуси нас храни.
Oh. Portion of our concert with the wellspring of Western classical music, Johann Sebastian Bach. His innovations in music affected all who came after him, and even today we find solace, introspection, and timeless beauty in his works. Performing two movements from Bach's cello suite number 3 in C major will be Andrew Park, a cellist from Toronto, Ontario. After playing with the Toronto Symphony Youth Orchestra and its chamber groups, as well as soloing with his high school orchestra, he moved to Calgary to study with the faculty at the Mount Royal Conservatory. He has been spending this year to focus on performing and improving his skills as a chamber musician, soloist, and orchestral musician before beginning his undergraduate degree in music. Writing and performing his own music, Andrew also works collaboratively with other musicians in other genres to widen his musical knowledge as well as to satisfy his curiosity. He performs two movements from Bach's third cello suite in C major.
Thank you.
Romaniuk is a passionate advocate for Ukraine through her musical endeavors as a singer, composer, and artistic director. In addition to releasing an album of Ukraine cabaret songs last year, she recently performed in and artistically directed a musical production she created entitled Molitva Heroyam, a community prayer for the fallen heroes of Ukraine. This concert is also her initiative, all funds raised at which will be presented to the military hospital in Lviv, Ukraine, where she travels there to perform this April. As part of this concert tour, she has also been invited to sing at the Odessa Opera House, Potocki Palats, in Lviv, and at the Kyiv Philharmonia. She will sing the beautiful alto aria from Bach's St. Matthew's Passion with Lindsay Harrell on violin and Cheryl Emery on piano. Cheryl is highly in demand in and around Calgary as a collaborative pianist. She is an alumna of the Franz Schubert Institute in Austria, as well as of the University of Calgary, McGill University, and the University of Vienna, completing her performer's diploma under the supervision of renowned pianist Julius Drake. This piece has biblical sources. "Have mercy on me, O Lord," are Peter's words as he realizes his betrayal of Jesus. Within this piece are musical metaphors of the cross on which Jesus was crucified, traces of perhaps the greatest metaphor of suffering, forgiveness, and redemption known to the modern Western world.
Thank you.
violin since the age of 8 and recently graduated from the University of Victoria with a Bachelor of Music in Performance. She has studied with violin teachers Linda Huddleston, Peter Ellis, Sharon Stannis, and is currently studying with Bill Vandersloot at the Mount Royal Conservatory. Lindsay has served as a concertmaster both in the Festival Orchestra of Lutheran Summer Music Academy and the University of Victoria Orchestra, as well as participating in the National Youth Orchestra of Canada in 2012 and 2013. In May of 2013, Lindsay was selected from among numerous NYOC alumni to be a part of the Canada Indie National Youth Orchestra, which took place in Bangalore. Sonata number 1 in G minor for solo violin is the first in the set of 6 works for unaccompanied violin, 3 sonatas and 3 partitas by J.S. Bach. They were completed in the year 1720. The sonatas are each made up of slow movement, a fugue, another slow movement, and a last final finale. Today, just the first and last movements of the G minor sonata will be performed.
Thank you.
Contralto traces the tragic arc of the life of a beautiful young woman named Isabella. We meet her at sunset in a lush golden field with her beloved. They spend a night of wild and romantic passion together, the likes of which this earth has never seen. But come daybreak, she awakes to find her lover dead. From this point on, all traces of passion and life flee from her. She wanders listlessly, caring for her old father. Her eyes are black but do not shine. Her eyelashes are washed away with tears. Her mouth and lips are like dead things, and through her translucent skin, one may even see the light passing through. Her final prayer is that she may be afforded that which eluded her in life, peace. Il tramonto, the sunset.
Thank you. Thank you.
two folk songs from the Auvergne region of France. You will immediately notice that these songs are not in French, but in Auvergnat. Like the Lemko people in Ukraine, whose language and songs have a beautiful character all their own, the people from Auvergne are proud of their culture. Only a handful of people still speak this language today, so let us all revel in the strange beauty of the sounds of these words as you listen.
Thank you.
musician from Calgary. She has a variety of interests, including languages, philosophy, and folk song, but thinks that above all, her greatest joy lies in music making. She is particularly focusing on viola and voice this year, while also continuing her studies in piano and violin, and is the artistic director of the McKenna Family Quintet. She is inspired in the search for more effortless and beautiful expression, as well as by the opportunity to share such music with others. Edmund Rubra was an English composer who lived from 1901 to 1986. Many of his compositions were written for voice, and those written for other instruments were often based on melody fragments from songs or chants. This piece is based around a crucifixion hymn song in many liturgies on Good Friday.
Hello everyone, I just wanted to say a couple more words about this piece. It is a crucifixion chant.